ready for this?
Oh, yeah.
Salutations, everyone. It's your boy Beef Stroganoff here, coming back at you with another lit savage banger hit video for all y'all in the world, neighborhood, place. Coming at you live with the Max Factory Good Smile Company Figma Corrin, based on their female appearance from the game Fire Emblem Fates, which is that game that came in two halves, a bit like the Titanic. Well, I say two halves, it was more like two sides to the same waifu minted coin. A bit like Two-Face's asshole. But yeah, that was a good game, you know, at least top 5 games to come out on June 25th, 2015. So, let's push her out of the way and look at the box for a second. So, it's made by Figma, what a twist of fate that was. It's product number 334, and it has the official Nintendo seal of quality, which means it's higher quality than your average kangaroo anus. As you can see, still in the box, I have her alternate face and the thingy from Dragon Tales. Well, hey, she does turn into a dragon, so it might just be that dragon thing from Dragon Tales. Now, as you can see, there's a couple other bits in there, but we'll come back to those in a second. We got a picture of someone on the side of the box that could be Corrin, could also be an imposter. You never know in this modern day. On the back of the box, we have a bunch of people that look an awful lot like Corrin doing poses that she did in the game. There's also a lot of words in a language I do not understand. I don't read anime. And there's also a thing that says 15 and up, which is what the parents of the previous owner of this figure should have read before giving it to their dumbass. But we'll come back to that in time, don't you worry. Another picture of Corrin on the other side of the box. And it's got the same picture of Hannah Montana on the top and bottom of the box. How about that? Are you amused? I know I am. Right, that's it for that. Moving back to the figure. So yeah, here she is in all of her glory, and let's just say, I'm gonna need a jar to go with her, cause she looks pretty tasty, pretty spoopy, pretty nice looking, if I do say so myself. So right now, I have her in her classic pose of posing postures. You know, very articulate this figure is to be able to pull off such a dynamic pose. Doing a little turnaround. The stand here goes directly into her spine, which generally is not a good thing, but you know, she powers through it. She's got hair that flows like hair does. Getting that up close and personal look at her, seeing all of her fine detail. I like all that painting and sculpting that's going on there. Looks pretty, pretty nice. And it's amazing. Up until that exact moment, I didn't even notice that there was a little chip in her hair or something. Do y'all see that? I see that. I didn't even see it until I turned the camera on. It's amazing. You find something new every day. Giving her more of a turnaround. So, she doesn't have her cape. As you might have saw earlier, it's in the box. The reason for that is, the previous owner of this figure was a fucking dumbass. I don't know who they was, but they mama should have slapped them. I bought this used, and yeah, both cape pieces were broken off by the time I got it. And the previous owner made a very, very piss-poor attempt to repair the damages. I don't know if y'all can see that, but there's some very obvious glue residue on this thing. Like, it's just caked in glue. I don't know if they were using fucking Elmer's, I don't know if they were six and they just squirted the whole bottle onto it with their eyes closed whilst having to juggle 15 flaming babies and a baseball bat, blindfolded, naked, and with the controller unplugged. You know, something crazy that would warrant this fucking atrocity. Cause this is just sad. This should be a crime. This is an actual hate crime. But yeah, if someone out there wants to send me a good Corrin, please get in touch. But I digress for now. Anyway, let's just show off the rest of her and get to the articulation. We got her immaculate, crafted feet. They look good. You got them straps there. Got all that nice toe definition. Got nice calves, nice thighs. Ooh, upskirt got a little naughty there for you. Looks good, looks good. Whoa, that's a stand there. You like stands? I know I do.
And there we go. Whoa, ho, ho. And there's her wrist. That's a good looking wrist. So, articulation time. So, since it's a Figma figure, you'd expect the articulation to be pretty good. And it is. Let's start at the bottom. Hinge joint at the toes. Hinge at the base of the foot. And a rotation joint. Get some pivot action out of it. Over 90 degrees of bend at the knee. The leg can straight out a bit, make it look like she got chicken legs. A little bit of rotation. That's about the range of splits that she has. And you could bend her leg this way. That's unhealthy. But you could do that if you needed to for some reason. Ball joint at the waist. Ball joint at the thorax. Ball joint at the shoulder joint. Ball joint at the shoulder proper. Hinge joint at the elbow. And rotation. Ball joint at the wrist. Is that a ball joint? We're gonna call it a ball joint at the head. And the hair moves. This little torso skirt thing moves for clearance reasons. Stand just plugs right into her back there, and boom, you're on your way. So, for a size comparison, here she is with a copy of Fire Emblem Three Houses, Chrom Amiibo, Lucina Plush, Corrin Plush, and of course Zoe. So, Corrin figure. I'm gonna have to give it a 10 out of 10. You know, I feel like it'd be a sin to give it anything less than that. You know, maybe the one I have, maybe a 9.5 due to the cape being bullshit, but that's not her fault. That's the previous owner dipshit's fault. But, you know, the figure itself, solid 10 out of 10. Obviously. So, in conclusion, ain't nobody give a fuck about the male Corrin.